This isn't what we normally associate with gardening.
This here is a pile at a nursery that's built up over several years. This is the hidden part of the nursery business that people don't really see, is all the trash that is generated.
Tens of millions of plant containers, pots, baling twine, and greenhouse plastics wind up here or in backlot dumps and burn piles.
What we're looking at here is HDPE pots that come from nurseries. It's a number 2 on your recycling code of plastics. These are used pots that come from either the nurseries or from homeowners.
Until now, this was nothing but trash. No recycler would take it, no nursery would touch it.
The nurseries don't want to reuse them because if they have a disease in them, they bring it to their nursery and they get a disease in their nursery, it could destroy thousands or millions of plants at some of these larger nurseries, and it could destroy their business.
Husband and wife team Alan and Dari Jongsma created a solution. They run Agri-Plas, Oregon's only agricultural recycling center. It's the answer to a problem that lies largely out of sight.
If you were to take pound for pound of curbside recycling of what is out there, and then you take pound per pound of what's in agriculture, the ag will either match or exceed all of total curbside per pound.
Some of the big nurseries go through millions of pots when they're in their transplanting season. A nursery will get maybe a tray of 64 plants, and they'll transport it out of that tray into a little bigger pot, maybe say like a 4-inch pot like this, and they'll grow them to a certain stage, and then that nursery may sell it to another nursery that grows it to a different stage before it gets into the retail end of the market. Before we started in this area taking them, they were all going to landfills, or they were being stacked in the back of properties on nurseries, or put in holes in the ground and buried, and various things. They weren't being recycled. And we have a process of grinding this, and we have a home that can take it after we process it.
Planting pots, greenhouse covers, milk jugs, even pesticide containers arrive here every day. And spaghetti-like piles of baling twine fill this place, the byproduct of hundreds of seed farms and hay presses that line the Willamette Valley. While it's hard to imagine the ecological problems caused by baling twine, consider that in 6 years, Agri-Plas recovered 15 million pounds of twine that would otherwise be dumped or burned.
Well, we look at this as twine, even though it's tons and tons of hay, but on these, for every ton of hay here, you got almost a pound and a half of twine on every ton. So when we see 1,000 ton of hay, we think, oh, there's 1,500 pounds of twine more for us that we'll be bringing into our facility.
The very first year in Marion County, we shipped out 2,068,000 pounds of baling twine. Now, we're not considering horse people, we're not considering cows, we're not considering anything but just a few hay presses. So if you were to instrumentally take everybody or everything, you can only begin to imagine how much is there.
Many cars share something in common with hay bales. Once the hay bales are broken down, the leftover twine is collected, melted down, and refashioned into auto parts.
This is the plastic film that comes off the greenhouses at the nurseries. They generally change this anywhere from 1 year to 4 years, take the film off and put new cover on. We've got some large users of it here in the United States now that make plastic lumber. There's large end markets for that.
Almost everything here can be reused, but sorting through mixed materials and trash is a fact of life for recyclers, including Agri-Plas. It's most evident when plastics from the home are dumped here.
This is a plastic wrapper that came off of something in there. We also have the milk jug top, which is an LDP. It's a low-density polyethylene versus the milk jug, which is a high-density polyethylene. If you mix all this together, you'd have a product that would not be worth anything.
It's cheaper for nurseries to just burn or bury their waste. It's Alan's job to convince them to do otherwise.
We really didn't want to go in and say, we just want these type of pots, or we just want this. We wanted to be able to go to the nursery and say, we'll take all your scrap plastic. In other words, all your pots, all your pesticide containers, the film off your greenhouses, your styrene trays. It's one stop, and we take all their trash, basically.
Before all of this, Dari spent her days managing beauty salons. Now she finds new markets for what used to be trash.
Whoever thought I'd grow up to be a trash queen? I mean, you know. You know, queen of the trash, okay. You should have heard my parents when I said, guess what I'm gonna do, Mom? And they just looked at me and went, oh gosh, here she goes again. But it works.
There are over 2,000 operating nurseries in Oregon. Only 50 supply Agri-Plas. But in a single week, those 50 nurseries divert 800,000 pounds of plastic out of the waste stream. And word is spreading.
It's like we'll have people come in on the weekends, and we'll come in and we will have plastic from the front of our barn almost to the street. We're now on the hotline to where if there's something no one else will take, go find Dari, she'll take it. I mean, we get kayaks, we get doggy igloo houses, we get the little swimming pools. I mean, but we find a home for it.
Okay, we'll kick her on and we'll show you.
The plastics meet their fate at the granulator. It's special design air cleans and grinds material without using water. With no wastewater runoff, Agri-Plas eliminates a problem that plagues other recyclers. And all the pots, buckets, and crates are spit out as these plastic chips, the raw material for new products.
This product right here is polypropylene. It's ground pots, nursery pots. We sell to a company that will melt it and mix a blend of 10 to 20% in with a virgin plastic to make a new pot. This is just about 2 days of product that we ground. There's about 24,000 pounds in this container.
Cleaning all this material by hand is time-consuming and expensive work. High overhead and low profits are why Agri-Plas is alone in the market.
We don't make a lot of money on this, but that's the overall goal, that in years from now, you won't find piles like this laying out in the countryside and buried and burned.
I think with the nursery industry, when they don't have solutions, and it is a major problem, it's not something they want to publicize. And I don't blame them. But there's been several people before us that had tried it. No one ever in 25 years has been able to pull this off. Everyone has failed. Except me. I'm the kind of person that's in for the long haul.
It's hard to change the idea of agriculture as a refuge beyond the problems of consumption and waste. But this environmental solution to waste is taking hold, even in a business where old ways die hard.
I think we've come to the point now that if we don't, we're going to kill ourselves. There's only so much Mother Earth has to give. And if we don't start appreciating it, we won't have anything left. Unfortunately, it's human nature to, you don't appreciate anything till it's gone. And then it's like, oops. Well, we need to get that oops before the oops really hits. So that's kind of where I'm coming from.